you know how rockets work? Briefly, they work by shoving out mass behind them, and then somehow that causes them to move forward. We're going to learn how that works with linear momentum and collisions. Start by defining linear momentum and then using it to look at impulse and collisions and the conservation of linear momentum that can be used to analyze that sort of behavior. Then we'll go into a little bit more details on collisions before ending up with looking at shoving mass around. First, linear momentum. If we have mass moving with some velocity, then it has a linear momentum that's equal to mass times velocity. The rate of change of our linear momentum is equal to the net force that's applied to it, which is Newton's second law. So sums of your forces are equal to dp dt. You might be used to sums of the forces are equal to mass times acceleration. And if we start with our linear momentum and substitute in mass times velocity, we can see that we have dmv dt. If you do a product rule, you take the derivative of the first thing times the second thing plus the derivative of the second thing times the first thing, and we get dm dt times v plus mdv dt, which simplifies since dv dt is equal to acceleration to dm dt v plus ma. If our mass is a constant, which most of the things, if you've been working physics problems up till now, you probably deal with a lot of masses that stay the same, then your mass doesn't change with respect to time, so this is zero, and this whole term goes away, and you're just left with the sums of the forces are equal to mass times acceleration. However, this momentum formulation gives us a way of dealing with if our mass is not constant over time, we can now consider that.